Hey, what's up everybody? In this lesson, we're going to learn how to take a vectorized image, poster, you name it, and create your very own mockup using Adobe Illustrator. To get started, we're gonna use this stock image of this summertime cat. I think it is all of us during the summer, and it truly showcases what the summer is all about. We're going to go ahead and copy this vector to our clipboard. I'm going to hit Command C, or if you're on a PC, you can hit Control C. Once you have that copied, we're going to go through a different types of mockups that you may create. The very first one is, what if we wanted to put this logo on a sweatshirt to see how it's going to be? Now, this is indeed just a mock-up. It's for us or our client to get an idea of what this would look like in its final form. I'm going to go ahead and hit Command V or paste. And I'm going to scale down this image just a little bit, just so it can kind of fit in the realm of where this young man is pointing. That's looking pretty good. We can go maybe a little bit bigger there. You know, this looks okay. Nothing terrible with it, but there are some folds and some things that we could play around with. And so let's use a really cool tool in Illustrator to help us. To do this, you're going to need to grab your background image and then hold shift and grab your vector that you want to create the mockup of. I'm gonna then go to object. We're gonna go up to mockup beta. Now, the time you watch this video, this may be not beta anymore. They may have changed the name of it, but right now it is August 7th in 2024. We are going to use the mockup beta tool. I'm gonna hit create mockup. That's gonna go ahead and process the image. And it usually takes a few seconds depending on what you have open or what your computer's doing behind the scenes. There you go. You can kind of see it snap into place. If you don't have a specific image that you want, you can use a slew of the images that come in Adobe Illustrator. You have apparel and different branded graphics, and you can even preview those graphics on the specific elements. This is a really cool tool. Another great thing you can do is drag this anywhere you want on the hoodie. You can go ahead and scale it to your liking or make it bigger or smaller. And you can even, while it's selected, and one thing I want to point out is it has this circle around it. That means we're in the mockup tool. I'm going to go to my properties and then opacity, and I'm going to just change this to a color burn or a multiply to kind of get a fun kind of weathered look. That's just going to soften it a little bit. You don't have to do this. This is just something that can kind of help a little bit. That's one way we can use this summertime cat and now mock it up to be our very own shirt. What else can we do with this? Well, in this next image, we have our cat on this kind of empty wall. Imagine our cat is a poster or a type poster and we want to see what it looks like in our living space. Very easy. Grab the background, hold shift, grab the summertime cat, go to object, and go down to mockup and hit create mockup. It's going to do the same exact thing and process this image for you. What's really cool about this is it's going to not only place it on the wall, and that allows me to kind of go in and, you know, scale it down a little bit. I suggest pre-scaling these, but I can also drag this and put this on the floor. Or I can put this on the wall over here, or even, gosh, the wall over here. With a few clicks of a button and then going to that opacity filter, voila, we have an actual well-lit graphic. And if I hover just outside that circle, I can actually get a little bit of, you know, a little bit of a rotation happening. Very, very cool. Well, it gets cooler. I'm sure you've probably seen demos like this before where they put a logo on a can. When I initially went to do this, I thought, okay, there's no way it's going to, you know, work here. This other can, if you look at my image, is covering this image. So if I were to just do this the old school way and go to opacity and hit multiply, it's really bad. It's not working very well. But this is what's crazy. Notice that can in front. When I select my background, shift select my image, and I go to that tool, which now I have my toolbar up, I can just hit the create mockup. It's going to do something really amazing. Watch what it does here in a few seconds. It's actually gonna take that graphic and whatever Adobe magic is happening here, it puts it behind the other can. This is ridiculous. It knew there was something in front of it and it hit it. How amazing is that? And guess what? If I want to drag it on this can and then rotate that sucker in, I can do the same thing. It's that easy. The fact that it kind of, I don't think it's a mask, but it kind of isolated that can in front, and it did it really, really quickly without me having to hassle too much, is absolutely amazing. So again, a powerful tool. The possibilities are endless. You have pre-built choices. You can pull in your own photos that you've taken. I just wanted to take this moment in this very quick lesson to share all the amazing things the mockup tool can do for you. Hope you enjoyed this lesson, and I can't wait to see what you create.